This is not a game. This is a 12-week job interview. Never, ever, ever underestimate me.
14 people came to London in search of a job.
I don't like liars. I don't like cheats. I don't like bullshitters. I don't like schmoozers. I don't like arse-lickers.
They've come to battle it out for a job with Sir Alan Sugar.
I would have told you to piss off.
Tough and uncompromising, Sir Alan is at the top of his game with a global empire worth £700 million. He's offering one job with a six-figure salary.
I'm gonna fucking win this night if it kills me.
To get it, they'll have to work and live together and face a weekly business task.
You can't fucking fire me.
You feel the pressure is building?
This is the ultimate job interview.
You're fired. You're fired. You're fired.
Last week on The Apprentice. The candidates were invited to Tottenham Hotspur Football Club.
This is a businessman's dream.
Morning, how you doing? You got mobile phones?
Their task, to promote a mobile phone service, providing news to Spurs fans.
You got a phone on you?
Both teams had big ideas.
Can we put something on the pitch?
Why don't we get some flipping lunatic to parachute into the stadium?
They won't allow it.
No, I'm not, forget about asking.
But Spurs crushed their plans.
There are some new ground rules. No use of the pitch, no painting on it, no banners over it.
To have people basically renege on deals at critical times was very upsetting.
Oh, fucking, it's all right. Yep. You do what you have to do, but
fine.
You're destroying our property.
For Cyrus, the pressure was intense.
Because that's wrong. It's just, you know, it's just too much.
Probably she's feeling a bit tired and emotional because, you know, she's project manager and the pressure's on.
In the boardroom, the clear winner was Tim's team. And the spotlight fell on Syra.
Syra, what do you think? You got a solemn look on your face this morning.
I'll put my hand up. I was feeling a bit low. However,
well, why was you feeling a bit low?
Well, because I'm a human being.
Raj.
If you're looking for a salesperson, I'm not your man.
You keep saying that to me every time you sit in front of me. You're not my man for this. You're not my man for that. What are you my man for?
I have not said that at all. I have
said the camera doesn't lie.
Luckily for Syra, Raj talked himself out of a job.
I'm going to put you out of your misery, my friend. I'm sorry to say I'm going to have to let you go. You're fired.
Raj became the ninth casualty of the boardroom. Now only five remain to fight for the chance to become the apprentice. At the house, the surviving candidates wait to find out who will return from the boardroom.
I think that James has gone today, because I think that he probably doesn't fit into Salem's kind of image of who he wants as an apprentice as much as Si does.
I think she's got a good chance because she's a fighter.
Maybe he's just fed up of people fighting. Maybe he just wants them to do their job. I do think that Syra's going to cop for it.
Don't know.
I think he's fed up of hearing her spiel in the boardroom.
I think he likes her.
That's a woman's boobs. That's Si.
Told you guys,
who's the other one? It's Rama, isn't it?
It's
Rama.
Well done, you.
Hello, guys!
You ain't coming to me yet. Hello, mate.
We were sure Raj was coming back.
Did you say it was me?
I was sure that Raj and Sam were coming back.
Really?
Yeah, I really thought
you
so.
You bang. Why? Yeah.
just because of the way I think Shannon
thinks. Tell you what, I nearly went though.
Was it really close between you?
I thought I was a goner. He said to me, you are abrupt, you are abrasive, and you need to watch yourself and can't treat people like skivvies. He said, in my business, there's only one person with a big mouth. He said, and that's me. And I thought, you just want a servant then. Well, if you want a servant, I'm not the right person, because this servant will speak back and say, I don't think that's really a good idea. I think he just gave me one more chance and said, you're a gobby cow and you have to prove yourself next time.
To get down to the last seven is a big achievement. We're down now to the last five. That's huge.
I'm glad that particular task is over. Five of us left.
Three versus two now.
Yeah. And it's time to move on.
Hello?
Hello, it's Francis here from Sir Alan's office.
Hello, Francis, it's Paul here.
You'll be picked up tomorrow morning at 6:30 a.m.
Right, okay. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
20 quid and I'll give you the news.
The team set off, but they don't know where they're going. On the back seat of each car, a clue.
From the desk of Sir Alan Sugar.
Task 10.
I can't believe we lasted this long. Ah, okay. We've got a DVD.
This it is. Sir Al gets high tech.
For the first time.
Look at him.
Well, I'm sorry I can't be with you today.
Because as you can see, I've been at a
launch of one of my products in front of all my customers, all of the press, and a lot of the financial community.
I've been there pitching in the way that I have done over many years directly to those people.
The next task coming up for you two teams is a similar one. You are going
to have an hour, each team, live on national television, one of these selling channels.
No way!
The difference being is you won't know who you're talking to.
Oh,
I did. You'll be talking to a massive audience out there.
This task, you've got no time for mistakes. You can't do it again.
You're going to be under pressure.
Piece
because
of
if you fluff it, then you're not going to sell anything on top of looking a bloody idiot. And the team that loses, one of you,
is going to get fired.
Amazing.
No way.
I'm excited.
We want to know what we're flogging.
Yeah.
Some kitchen utensil that cuts cheese and then cucumber and you can turn it around, it's a helicopter, and you can barbecue it, you can grill it.
Okay, so the first thing that we've got to do is pick our project manager.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, I mean, I'm very open-minded about it, but on the other hand, you did it last time.
Yeah.
It's probably I should do it this time.
Okay.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's fine.
You're happy?
Yeah, I'm very happy.
All right.
Project manager goes well.
Well, we've all done two, maybe.
I haven't.
Ready for another win for another go?
I'm ready for another win.
I'm not sure I can take orders from a woman. Can we not just kick this around a bit more?
Paul, that's appalling that you say that.
I just shoot from the hip. Mim it is then.
Yes.
You're ordering everyone around. She'll be Miriam Hitler.
From the briefing, the task seems straightforward. But they're about to discover that selling, live, on a shopping channel, involves a lot more than standing in front of a camera. The customers are out there somewhere. The trick is to connect with them, even though they can't be seen.
Well, if you've got teenage daughters or granddaughters or niece...
Auditions will decide which team member does the selling.
5 seconds. 4. Hello there, and welcome this afternoon.
And in the wings, Sir Alan's eyes and ears, Nick Hewer and Margaret Mountford.
Good afternoon, everybody. Does this carpet look familiar to you?
It was much tougher than I expected, to be honest. There's so much going on, so much you've got to remember. Oh, I loved it.
Give me the item number next, please, Sarah.
The item number for this fantastic product is
313.
I hated it. Absolutely hated it. And it was really interesting because coming into this, I thought, oh, it's sales, it's natural, you know, it's going to be direct selling and I can talk for England. But to be quite honest with you, I absolutely hated that.
With practice, I could feel comfortable and confident with that.
I think I'm going to be quite happy on this one and I'll be honest, sitting behind and doing the kind of key, say this, say that. I didn't feel comfortable doing that.
Oddly, the candidates who are top salesmen in other tasks flunk the test.
And, let's be honest, that after 2 years,
If it falls to pieces, you've only lost £24.99.
God help us. When we did our screen test, Paul, who is the ultimate salesman out of all of us, just flopped, really.
Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Miriam, on the other hand, she was just such a natural. Yes, she was nervous, but she remained calm all the way through that.
313-534-2499. Ladies and gentlemen, don't miss out.
This morning, I would have been more happy presenting, but it looks like I fell on my arse in presenting, and I don't think that I could turn that around in less than 24 hours and all of a sudden be a, you know, a star. That's bloody weird, and honestly, I'm a bit shaken up by that.
Yeah.
10th task,
yeah.
And I haven't fallen on my arse in any task.
But don't be hard on yourself, you went first.
Myself and Tim are going to be production. Miriam is going to be the presenter. I think she thought that being project leader, she had to be at the desk, making sure that everything was running smoothly. But, you know, I said to her, look, Miriam, if you're a good presenter, if that's where your strength is, then you're just going to have to trust me and Tim to do a good job in production.
The producer's first job is to choose which products to sell. And the two on-screen sellers, Miriam and James, aren't allowed to participate. There are products in the vast range on offer that will sell themselves. But the candidates don't know which they are. And they're not allowed to ask.
My first item for you chaps is edible pens. Now I can see you like this one. And this is actually based on a wolf design. Yeah, it's very, very plush.
I think you and me both are thinking that that craft stuff that we saw there was a lot of tosh. Edible pens, please.
I don't like the wolf jacket, the pens, all of that. I did not like them.
That was all tosh.
We have our extendable ratchet action loppers. Next one I have for you is the vanishing point safety knife. A 2 million candle power rechargeable spotlight. And as you can see from the wall over there, it's extremely bright.
The candle torch I thought was okay.
I just thought the opposite. I thought, okay, it's a torch, so what? A torch, it's just a torch.
Ratchet action loopers and pruners.
They're cheap. How much is it?
That's £625. In this set, you get the comforter, you get a quilt cover, a fitted valance sheet, and two pillowcases. You can basically do your whole room. £49.99.
It's a bit garish, though, isn't it? A whole room in that. What do you think?
Got some duffers in there.
There's some duffers that we have to pick out, but listen, we can do. We've done everything so far. We can do this as well.
While the boys are quick to criticise, Syra digs for clues that will help James to sell.
This product's called True Sleeper.
How do you make that look sexy on TV? Have you sold any of these before on here?
Yes, I have, yes.
You have, right, OK.
It's basically a home yoghurt-making system.
How would you demonstrate it? How long have you been selling these?
Well, water features and generals I've been running sort of over the summer season for about 3 years.
Ah, that's good.
This
Any celebrities using it at the moment?
No.
How much was this again? It's a good idea, but it's quite complicated to explain, isn't it? The audience is 40 plus, mainly women.
It appeals just as much to men or women. Indeed, women buying it as a gift purchase.
Gift for present, yeah. There's quite a few products that I like, but there's a lot of information in my head and I'm kind of trying to think about so many things. Like, I've got to think about the audience at that time, I've got to think about what James will enjoy selling. So there's a lot to think about and I've got to make decisions really quickly.
Number 212.
As presenters, the project managers forfeit their chance to help with the buying. So they spend time rehearsing their selling skills.
Now, I just want to show you once again, because another beautiful aspect of this watch is that you can actually adapt.
We have got to realise that product is critical. Right. Sir Alan, in every single task, has gone straight down to who picked the product.
Well, forget that. It's about the product is what's going to make us the money.
As well.
The two teams are not permitted to sell identical products. So where they both want the same item, they must negotiate. The boys hatch a plan to outwit Syra. They'll make her reveal her choices first, then claim to have picked the same items so she can't have all her favourites. Channel executive Tommy Lorimer will arbitrate. Tim and Paul have managed to keep him in the dark too.
What did you want from Fashion and Craft?
The ones that I would like, please, are yogurt and flavours.
Yep,
the Kenwood grill and the Wonderflex three-piece cooking utensils.
Well, we wanted the Wonderflex.
Yeah.
And the Ezio and the grill.
Yeah, right. So we want the same three things on there.
Okay.
We're prepared to sacrifice.
I think you need to debate really quickly which ones you want.
What's your favourite? What's your absolute you will not budge on?
Ezio.
Okay, we won't budge on...
The Ezio.
No. We won't budge on the health grill.
Okay, so you have the health grill. Okay.
Fine.
And First Forte having the Ezio products.
Brilliant.
That then leaves Wonderflex.
Wonderflex we have to talk about.
Tell you what.
Go on.
You have the Wonderflex, and I'm going to go with the True Sleeper.
Okay.
You can't tut it there.
I didn't. I blew heavily.
What did you want totally from arts, from fashion and craft?
Okay, fashion and craft, I want the Polo Pancho, the edible pens, and the Wolf Spirit unisex jacket.
Fine.
Can we give you 2 out of 3? Because we fancied the poncho.
No, I want the poncho.
Well, that's a very greedy side.
We're giving you 2 out of 3.
No, I want the poncho.
You want the poncho
I
more
want
than
never
the other
Yes.
So you want the poncho as your top item?
Yes. I will take the poncho if you want to take any of the other two.
Let her have the poncho.
You can have the poncho.
Okay.
We've been nice to you, though. Remember that.
Okay.
Remember that.
We wanted that poncho.
Okay. I want to go to technology.
You give me yours first, because Sarah gave me hers first.
That's part of a negotiation.
Ah, Sarah goes first, does she?
She's opted to do so.
Lovely.
Cool. Okay, well, the ones that I'm going to go for are the DVD recorder.
Okay.
I'd like the 4000 camera, and I'd like the SingStar.
Well, once again...
They're the three I'd like.
And they're the three we want.
Oh, really?
The exact same three.
Exact same three.
Exact same three. Okay, well, I would like, out of all of those, the DV4000 camera.
So you'll give up the other two for the DV4000 camera?
Yes.
Okay, so that's a good deal for you?
That's a good deal. Yeah. That's a good deal. Thank you, Sarah.
Is that your negotiations done?
That's our negotiations
done. Apart from one other.
Which other?
You know the actual torch, the new one that's out? Yes.
You want that one?
I
as
wouldn't
well?
Mind that, please, yeah.
How did that slip through our net?
Well, okay. You want that one?
Yeah.
We had it down as one that we want ticked, but we'll give you that.
Okay.
Thank you, that's fine.
Okay. Sarah, have you finished? Are you happy with all the items you've got?
Yes.
Can we now have a private conversation now in terms of sorting out our items?
All right. Why would you want
to? We're allowed to do that.
You're allowed to choose as many products as you want, basically.
Fine.
We'll advise you as best we can as to how many you can have in the show.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah?
Okay, is that you done?
Yeah, that's it.
Thanks, well,
okay.
Very well. Shake hands and come out fighting tomorrow, yeah?
Indeed.
Brilliant.
Indeed.
We ticked as many as we possibly could. We'd compensate if we lost a good item.
Yeah.
Can we use this last 5 minutes to sort out the final 10 that we want and come back to you with our final 10?
As long as you've got 6 minutes,
that's perfect.
You can give me your list of products.
100% on that.
Fashion and craft, the slinky thing.
Yeah?
Right.
That's one.
That bedding. Yuck.
Yuck.
Oh, it's lovely, that bedding.
It could do a whole room.
Oh, please. Look like vomit. The gorilla. Yeah, those two tall lamps for 20 quid.
They're dead in the water already. They're dead in the water.
At least we know we've got a better product list.
You pulled a fast one then, in effect, by getting her to say
A classic negotiation for you get your opponent to say what they're willing to give and what they're doing, and then you offer something that you don't care about. Because none of the things that we were bargaining, we didn't care about. We were willing to give them up. So she thought we were giving something up, but we weren't. We were just negotiating.
I did feel the tiniest bit sorry for Sarah when she sat down. I felt a bit sorry for her, because there she was, by herself.
She had no negotiation experience.
No, indeed, but I felt a tiny bit sorry for her.
I think they kind of felt a bit sorry for me because I was on my own, but I think I was trying to make them feel sorry for me. I was in control all the time.
6 o'clock.
The products that I think will do well on the day will be the Polo Poncho, the actual pack of yogurts, and I think the Wolf Spirit jacket. They're going to be some of our key winners tomorrow.
Because I bought the wolf jackets.
Did she go for it in the
end? She bought the wolf jackets.
Oh, yes, because we gave them to her Lisa.
Exactly, and she bought them.
Time to head home, and a chance for Tim and Paul to boast about their negotiating skills.
But it's
looks
a good
like
one.
You got some brilliant products,
we
guys.
Did. Well, we compared really to theirs, those. I'll read you out what they got, right? They got a Pallapuccino, which is basically a hoodie, but like a scarf.
Don't slag it off, because you wanted it.
I thought it was a good item, but it's not great. It's only $14.90.
Okay.
Next, you've got the Wolf Spirit unisex jacket. When I'm telling you,
it's a fleece.
No one would ever buy this.
It's a fleece, and it's £45.
This thing, it's grotesque. It's something that an old granny would buy you, because they think it's you, something you wear, and you would never touch it. You'd clean the car in it. I'm telling you, I looked at it, and I was like, you're being serious, aren't you? And she was like, yeah, it's great. It's quality product, and it's rubbish.
It remains to be seen whether Tim's opinion will be shared by the buying public.
Sounds like you negotiated well, boys.
We did.
Brilliant.
We did good.
Way to go, guys. Yeah.
I think they were kind of thinking I was going to be really friendly and just let them have what they want, and I was just looking at them going, no. So we started off, and I was going first, and I said, I want this, I want this, I want this. They were trying to play tactics, and as far as I'm concerned, I was like, whatever.
Did they want the yoghurt?
Yes, big time. They went for the camera.
Yes, you got that. Though.
And I got that. What's important is that I got everything that I wanted to get.
That's good.
Whatever I pull out of this bag, you have got to love it, feel it, smell it, touch it, eat it.
If you laugh first, I'll kill you.
I won't.
But Syra has selected just six items for James to get to grips with in time for tomorrow's show.
You know what it's called. So what I'm going to bring out on the list first is that yoghurt making starter kit. This is it. Voila. There you go.
So this is what do you do with this?
This is basically made by NASA.
God, haven't they got anything better to do with their time?
The thing you have to ask yourself is, how much would you pay for a good night's sleep?
Paul and Tim have brought back 15 items, too many to sell in the 60-minute slot. But it does mean project manager Miriam can have a say in which ones they sell on the night.
We've got over 100 grand's worth of gear.
100 grand's worth of gear.
The big ones are the trouser press, the grill, and the garden hedge cutter.
I quite like that, because that's three sort of electrical
and they
style
all go together, don't
items,
they?
Which, yeah, can definitely work together, which is excellent. Bit of the Kenwood grill, the fast press, then bring the camisole in there, then go back to the grill, maybe go to the garden green hedge trimmer.
I think those are good products, you know.
They are. What do you think we bought them for?
What I'll try and do now is divide an hour into time.
Yeah.
You know, how much we should devote to each product to get a certain amount of return back.
Yep.
The biggest hit is, believe it or not, the hedge trimmer, because there's 300 of them and they're 94 quid each, which means we've got £28,200 worth.
Right, the next thing is the jacket that I've got. You've got to love this jacket tomorrow, James. James, you can't love this much tomorrow. It's a fucking thing worse.
Sorry to stop you there. Is this the one that you said was unisex?
Yes.
Right, let me try it on.
Wolf Spirit Zip Through Unisex. A lovely, lovely jacket. What does it feel like? Does it
synthetic,
feel
I'm going to come out in a rash.
It's back to the channel for the big day. After a short night's sleep.
We were all up till 12 o'clock last night. We're giving it our all, basically.
Hello, morning, gang.
After 9 tasks, we're knackered physically and mentally, but we're still going because we want to do the best that we can.
All right.
Yes, yeah.
Very good.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Seen our product list?
Yes.
What do you think?
Convinced they have the best list.
Do you want me to be honest?
Yes.
Miriam's team check it with a channel presenter.
Be really honest, you've not picked that well, in my opinion, at all. Really difficult products.
All of them?
Yeah. And there were certain products that we had on that list that are just instant sellers. You don't have to do anything for the moment you show them, they go. However, if you out of the products you've got, if you choose strategically and you demo well, then you could do okay.
Yeah. Don't worry, you.
I'm not worried.
You are.
I'm not worried.
Don't worry. We've done a good job.
I think I'm most concerned that as project manager, I've had to give up responsibility for some of the absolute fundamental decisions that will make or break this whole project. So I think I'm a little bit concerned about some of the decisions that have been made and about the way that this live hour is going to go and the fact that I can't be in two places at once and I just have to concentrate and do my bit.
Sarah, good luck. I'll see you afterwards. I'm sure you do fantastic. I'm sure you do fantastic too, Jeff.
We will do our very best.
I think you can break a leg, all of that sort of stuff, and just go and make the channel some money, yeah?
I don't want to do all of this hard work to end up in the boardroom with the rudest man in Britain. Nick.
I want the whole hour to go as well as it possibly can. Quite frankly, that will be judged by whether we beat the other team or not, and that's what I want.
We've got 5 minutes before we kick off our one-hour live show. Tim and I are both a little bit apprehensive, but the important thing is that Tim and I carry the worry and that Miriam isn't worried. She's probably feeling a bit nervous. She wouldn't be human if she wasn't feeling nervous right now.
The teams have live evening slots between 5 and 7. So Sir Alan leaves the office early to watch the broadcast in the comfort of his own home.
You've got to understand that all his apprentices are young, and I have to take into account that they will not be perfect. But, you know, like all things, you can get a view whether they're a total disaster and never be able to do it, or whether they're 80% there. So, like in all the other tasks, really, no one's ever been perfect in each one because, you know, experience is the most important thing in business.
Is it gorgeous?
It'll be all right.
Yeah, okay. We're going to be a good team.
We've got everything we need.
You're okay for the first three products?
I'm okay with everything.
Right.
She's fine. Good. We've got everything here. We'll be with you every single step. Yeah.
Tim and Paul's job now is to feed clear information about the products to the on-screen seller through an earpiece.
Can you hear us? It's Paul and Tim.
Mim, can you hear me? Good, we're with you, yeah?
We're here, Mim.
Okay, Miriam, come into you in vision. Camera 7, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and cut and cue. I've got some amazing products for a fun-filled, packed hour.
Brilliant smile.
So I want to start off by talking to you a little bit about the Kenwood Healthy Grill. So I'm just going to leave
good these girl, that's really
here,
good.
As you can see they're grilling perfect. Nicely. Get absolutely beautiful, tasty, flavoursome food.
Give me some emotion.
I've got some absolutely wonderful tomatoes, beautifully grilled with the lines across them. Got some burgers.
Taste something, then.
And these wonderful, I think I might just have to. A little bit naughty, but
excellent, excellent.
Oh, it's so good. Packed full of flavour, but no
we're already
grease
selling,
Mim.
We're already selling.
I'm not having to add any oil to my grill. It's a non-stick surface, and I'm not having to do anything.
First person
else
on the line, Mims. They're biting already. First person on the line.
Sir Alan, the armchair critic, can watch his candidates in action live for the first time.
A bloody employer, that will. I'm telling you, she's very good. Possibly speaking a bit too fast. That's the only criticism I would make. The bottom line of this task is who's taken the most amount of money, and that's going to really be because they've picked the right products. But from a sales point of view, you ain't going to get much better than what she's doing.
Sam, are we ready to move?
Where do you want to go to? Sorry.
Item two.
Right, team vision next, team vision on 7. Ready with the sing star, guys. I think that we need to chill out a little bit. We need to just be a little bit more relaxed.
Go back to my lounge area now, Mim.
Hold it
there. Go to the sing star.
Go to the DVD recorder, Mim.
Yeah,
DVD recorder.
And what I want to take you to is get back to my lounge and show you a brilliant DVD player.
Director, go to DVD recorder, please.
Now, the DVD player is absolutely is great.
Thank you.
I know.
We want the DVD.
And it's £239.
I didn't have a shot of the DVD.
There you can see. Replaces VHS.
Guys, you can't just change your mind like that. Eight next.
Apologies, Sam.
Give me a pack shot on eight.
I really want to highlight some of the features of this because I think that it's something which I've never seen before.
Do you have full photographics? Do you have VT? Think about it. Right. Not be one step ahead.
Okay.
Help out.
The DVD players have replaced the VHS.
Mim, you sold yourself first one.
I'm your VHS player.
She has not stopped bunnying for 25 minutes nearly. She can talk non-stop and doesn't come up for air. I wonder if she's married. Poor husband. My God. The geezer's got to be stone deaf.
Is she OK, yeah? Miriam, are you all right? She's got a problem with her earpiece.
The director goes for a station break.
2.5 minutes on a break.
Guys, I need some feedback from you.
Camisoles, please. Camisoles, please.
Camisoles
are flying through.
How much we've sold? $400.
Are you selling stuff?
Where's the money? Find the money. Set.
Yep.
And then we'll
camisoles. Listen, one thing you can do is remind me of my product, my item number, and my price in my ear.
Yes, no problem. I'll do that.
All right, stand by, everybody.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Judy, you are still looking radiant and fabulous. That colour so well.
Would she go nightclubbing in it?
So 95% polyester on these and 5% elastane.
Is that something to brag about? 95% polyester. Very good.
Just want to show you the colours once more so you know what we have for you today. Here we have
black.
Black.
Brown.
And then we have brown.
Cream, which is flying off the shelves.
We do have cream, which has been absolutely flying off the shelves.
Navy.
Which is the new black.
New black.
People are saying it's the new black.
And white.
And then we have white here.
Which is also the new black. Be funny, Mim.
I wonder who's directing her. Tim and Paul, what are they actually doing now? There can only be one of them keeping an eye on how sales are going. So one of them must be pretty much redundant in the back room.
1 minute on show.
Now, I just want to recap a little bit what we've done today.
Mention the iron, make sure that you highlight the benefits.
Go to the iron.
There's no point going to the iron. It's not
serious. You're sure the iron?
If you've got one.
Put it on, please, director. Yeah.
Watching the iron.
We also showed you the fast press.
Remember how effective the fast press was.
The beautiful camisole tops, which are modelled by the lovely Julie.
She's nearly sold 100 of those camisole tops.
So just £7.90 for those camisole tops. You can brighten up your wardrobe.
Counting you out then.
Thank you so much. It's been really, really lovely.
Six.
Get dialing.
5, 4.
And
three,
whatever you do, stay tuned.
Wait. Well done.
Mims, you are a star. You are an absolute star, Mims. Well done, girl.
Oh, do you want a job?
Yeah.
I said I'll be calling you tomorrow when I get fired.
Let's show the rest of my team how a producer can pick something up in 1.5 seconds.
Oh, don't put the pressure on.
If anyone's going to do it, you're going to do it.
The 6 o'clock handover.
Come on in, Sora.
Just 2 minutes for the teams to swap.
Okay, you happy, James?
Can anyone hear me? Hello, somebody?
Yes, I can hear you, Sarah.
Okay, you'll be
Sam, can I have graphics on what's coming up ready and clip one?
30 seconds.
Clip
yeah,
one.
Just wait a second.
You're number one.
It'll be over here.
This will be on camera.
Stand by!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
5 seconds, quiet!
3, 2, 1, cutting cue, James.
Hello, good evening. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.
James, move it on quickly.
Let's start off our show, top of the show tonight, the yogurt maker.
Start using and talking about the product.
So let's talk about the product. This is the yogurt maker step.
James, take a yogurt out of the fridge. Take a yogurt out of the fridge. Let me show you.
Straight out of the fridge. This is what it's going to look like when you take it out of the fridge.
And wobble it to the camera. Shake that thick, creamy yogurt.
So here it is. So all you do is you take the lid off.
fresh,
look at
creamy,
that. It's fresh,
full of bacteria,
it's creamy,
nice
and I tell you what,
bacteria.
It's solid. Look at that.
Shake it or
I tell you what.
And smile.
My producer's telling me not to drop it all over the place, but I tell you what.
This is delicious. Put your finger in it.
This is so solid.
It,
I'm going to stick
Go
my
on,
finger in it.
Put it in your mouth.
Oh.
Well
Ooh.
Done.
I tell you what,
well
that,
done.
That is delicious.
That's so delicious. I'm going to have more.
Not bad, different style, not bad. He repeats himself a lot, and that's maybe what is needed. Not as professional as Miracle, but good is good.
Sorry, guys, we're going to go to item number... Fuck, where is it? We're going to go to item number 7, which is the light.
The light?
Yes.
Torch, make sure you've got the torch, Sarah.
This here is the 2 million candle power torch.
Next.
Now play with your toy. Show them the big face at the front.
It's got a wonderful, wonderful big face at the front. That is 2 million candles worth.
People are phoning in, they like what you're doing with it. Keep it on this product, it's fantastic.
We've got a lot of people interested in this, so give us
James,
a call.
I'm going to give you some key points here, and I want you to repeat them after me.
And it's really, really amazing.
Stop saying really and follow
highlight.
What I'm saying.
So this is a quartz halogen spotlight.
Completely,
and it's completely
versatile.
It's high quality
and
maintenance-free product.
Where do you want to go? Where do you want to go?
I don't know. I want
to
go to
then.
Item number... Fuck.
8, your true sleeper.
Item number 8, please. We're going to go over to the mattress.
Oh, let's go to dining room. Quickly, guys.
Walk slowly.
We're going to go over to our next product.
True sleeper and bonus pillows.
Bed. And bonus pillows.
It's viscoelastic foam.
If I push my fingers down there, it's coming back to its original shape here.
Of course it's coming back to its original shape. It's a lump of bloody foam, that's why. Viscoelastic foam. What a lot of bollocks. What a pile of toot that is there, honestly. A lump of bloody foam for £154. I'll tell you what, son, you sell any of them, you're a bloody good salesman, that's all I can say.
But Sir Alan is about to be forced to eat his words.
You've got people interested in this already, James. Well done. 20% of the double has already gone.
Oh, I'm just hearing from Sarah, my producer.
Well done.
20% of the double has already gone.
Fantastic.
So come on, keep calling.
So this is good. This is where they're better than Miriam. I've got to tell you, just winding people up.
James, listen to me. Listen to me, James. We have sold out of the double mattress, true sleeper.
We've just sold out of the double sleeper mattresses. So if you're thinking of calling for one of these items, they sell out fast.
We've sold out now. You better get in quick. You better come on. This is, I mean, the oldest trick in the book, obviously, but £154 a pop. They sold 10. That's £1,500. You see, it's a classic example. You sell one of those. And you've got to sell, what, nearly 15 of the torches.
We're going to move on to the next item, because this is really special. This is the...
Can we have a jacket for James?
Jacket.
James?
Have a look at Nina with the jacket.
Go, James,
and
I'll tell you what, get the jacket.
How about if I try one of the jackets on myself? Because I tell you what, these are brilliant.
Why? The wolf jacket lights up the switchboard and immediately becomes a top seller.
Really, really well. Lovely, warm, comfortable feeling.
This is warm, dry,
put it on, James, put it on.
I'm going to put this on nice and carefully here.
James, it comes in sizes.
And it also comes in a number of sizes. I'm just trying to find the arm here.
Imagine yourself walking the dog
on a cold day.
It's like wearing a duvet out there.
It's like a second-hand car salesman with that jacket on there. Would you buy a car from him? Different style to Miriam, different style. They seem to be spending far more time on each product, but of course, time will tell.
Here's our premier product. This is the powerful 2 million candle power spotlight.
James, we've only got 56 seconds.
It's got a quartz
Show it to the camera,
spotlight.
James. And put,
so it's got a quartz
it, that's
halogen
it. Show
spotlight.
The face. Put your
so
finger around
that.
The face.
And then look at the way that it works there.
It's been one of our best sellers this evening.
20 seconds, stand by,
Premier
please.
Premier product.
All I can say is you've seen some wonderful, wonderful products tonight.
In 10,
with us.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3,
thank you very much
2,
indeed. And
1,
goodbye.
0.
Thank you.
I just can't believe we've just done that. I mean, I like to work under pressure, but my God, this is pressure. Big pressure. Oh, sweetheart! Oh, I'm so sorry if I burst your eardrum.
Got louder! Louder!
Because you weren't fucking listening!
Next morning, Sir Alan heads for the boardroom. The five remaining apprentices await their fate.
Yes. Okay. You can go through to the boardroom now.
It is the first time that I've really been able to watch the whole task myself, because I sat and watched it at home.
Did you buy anything?
Not from you, I wouldn't. No. But Miriam, I thought you were absolutely spectacular.
It was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life.
James, considering from what I heard that you had a foghorn blasting in your ear all the time, you didn't do too bad. So, team leader here was?
Me.
Right, product choice then.
The boys had to do it because that was in the scheme of things. So I felt, you know, as project manager, I had to at least do some effective delegation, and I gave them some parameters, things that I would want from the products they chose. A lot of people buy from a presenter rather than buying a product. So people were looking at us going, who are these new people trying to talk to us about products? And
didn't look like a new person, I've got to tell you that. Sarah, when you finally decided that he was going to be the front man, was it then you that chose all the products?
That's right. I basically did the same process as them, went to see all the buyers, and my key criteria in the back of my mind was, what is an exclusive product, if there is any? What could James handle on the night? And what can I sell effectively? And what would the audience want?
Let's get around to these numbers now, shall we? Margaret?
Impact got 2017.
Wow.
Nick.
Yeah.
This is your team. Right, first four test numbers.
A staggering £5,407.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Well done.
Well done.
Well done.
That is,
well done.
That is a big gap, isn't it? A big gap. Very well done.
Well done, guys.
Well,
thank you.
I cannot believe these bloody beds. Look at this.
We sold out of the double, didn't we?
Over £2,000 worth of foam. Unbelievable. We are in the wrong business, you are. I tell you what's going to happen. You've got a treat coming to you. You're going to Skibo Castle in Scotland. You're going to need to get on your bike soon, because they've got a private jet lined up for you at Luton Airport. Archery, horse riding, golf lessons. On your way. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Well done, guys.
Impact, we'll see you back here in the boardroom, where, you know, we're going to have to go through things and one of you eventually is going to get fired. Despite losing, I think Miriam was absolutely superb.
They said that with minimal training, she could get a job there.
Obviously, I'm feeling very disappointed. It's never nice to lose a task, and once again, having done absolutely everything I possibly could have done and given over 100% of myself, and to have lost is disappointing.
Right, the way Sir Alan was talking to Miriam, he thought that she was just a shining star. It doesn't look like he understands particularly that everything that came out of her mouth was coming from me and Tim.
And it was only for yogurt that only needed the fridge. We really needed a kitchen for the grill.
It's going to be an interesting boardroom. Sir Alan's got to make a big decision now. It basically looks like it's between me and Paul.
So that's not an exciting proposition for me to go into a boardroom with.
If you ask us a question, where do you think the money is?
We Paul didn't give as much as Tim did on the production side. I think that he has to be very careful about his attitude. I think he has to be careful about the way he treats people, his respect for women in business. An overall feeling I have is that, you know, he doesn't necessarily have the qualities to be The Apprentice.
We
didn't even take 800 quid on them. I mean,
that's how I think.
In the boardroom, it's such a cauldron, you never know what to expect.
But at £7.90.
So Alan throws curveballs at everyone. So for me, it's about fighting my corner, doing what I have to do.
I don't think anyone can assume that just because he complimented me in the boardroom on my presenting skills that I'm safe from being fired. If he wants to fire me, he'll find a reason to fire me.
I'm not defeated yet. I am going to fight in there. I'm not going to go in there and say, look, shall I go home? But I've fought three times before, two against one, and I've won. You know, if 100 people tell you you're dead, lie down.
Oh, well done, look at you.
Here's to another victory, yeah. A really, really great victory, yeah. And well done. Yeah, you did a brilliant job.
So did you. Good teamwork.
Great teamwork.
Fantastic, well done.
Perfect.
I don't know if I can use the right words to justify how I feel, but this place is totally, amazingly beautiful. I've done the best that I can, and I know that when I do the best, I do get good results. So being in the top four is a big tick in the box for me.
I think I wanted to win this task more than any of the previous ones, because having been in the boardroom before, I didn't want to be there again. You know, the inspiration to win was just huge.
Oh, yes, that is good.
And there's still so much to play for. You know, there's the job to work for Sir Alan. That is the biggest treat of all, in my eyes.
This gets better and better, doesn't it?
Now the game changes. Up till now, it's been teamwork, it's been working together, all that.
Here's to Sir Alan and his wolf jacket.
Now it's an individual, one-on-one, head-on clash.
For the three losers, it's time to face Sir Alan.
Francis, could you send the three of them in, please? You need to really tell me throughout the next series of questions that I'm going to ask you all here why I shouldn't fire you. I was convinced until I actually saw James come on with his stuff that you were going to win hands down. Why do you think you didn't?
There are several reasons. It's not all about presenting. A lot of it's about the product, because ultimately the product is what you're trying to sell. And I think that even though the products the guys picked were good, there were some products that would just sell, regardless of what you said about them, regardless of how you tried to present them, and we didn't have any of those products.
The two chaps chose the products, right?
Yes.
So are you implying to me that they made a bad choice?
I'm saying that product selection was absolutely key, and I'm saying that they weren't necessarily as in tune with their potential audience.
So, chaps, what was in your head when you was thinking about the products you were selecting from the list?
I had put down that we thought we could sell about 50 grills at 40 quid each. So that was £2,000. So when we went to see the bloke that actually sold the grills, we said, how many do you think we could sell of these grills in this time span at that slot? He said, easy, 100. So I said, well, I've put down 50. He said, well, you can double that.
Why didn't you sell 100?
Well, I don't know. If I knew that, then I'd be working there and making a fortune.
We left from the building rather jubilant, maybe a bit too cocky in retrospect, that we had the better list. We went home very happy.
Was that because you thought you pulled a fast one on Syrah, because you thought you got good product?
Both aspects of that. The fact is, I held a very good negotiation in terms of I knew what I wanted, and I led Syrah to give me all of her information in terms of the products she wanted. With hindsight, because I didn't know which products were better, the products I'd picked weren't the best ones, and she was left with the better products anyway.
Get yourself in that situation then. Lack of knowledge of the product?
Lack of knowledge.
We had 6 minutes, don't forget, Tim.
Backfired on you? Strategy of yours was that what you was trying to do was be dead shrewd, drop dead shrewd. Let Syrah talk first, see what she wants, and be belligerent in saying, well, I want that also.
There's nothing wrong with being belligerent, Sir Alan. It works in terms of what you do.
Well, it don't work in terms of what I do. If I was sitting there and there was a list of products there and I didn't actually agree with what the person said, I wouldn't, for the sake of it, just say I'm going to have the same to be disruptive. I'd think, good luck to you, dear. You want that? Thank you. That's your luck, but I'm going to have this.
You pretended you wanted some things so that she would then have to give up some of the things she wanted, and it backfired. You were in a complete muddle after she left, trying to get your list sorted.
I think that's unfair, Margaret. We weren't in it.
Fair? Hold on a minute. There's me thinking that we're running a dog-eat-dog business and we're talking about fair. Listen, son, we don't do fair here. The only fair you're going to get here is your bloody train fare home. I'm minded, actually, to invite the team leader to perhaps tell me who, if I was prepared to let someone swim off back to the house, who would you want that someone to be?
Probably Tim.
How do you feel about that, Paul? Would you expect that answer to have come out of Miriam's mouth?
Yes.
Do you think it's based on this project, or do you think it's more deep-rooted?
Miriam thinks I'm an arrogant git. And she thinks that Tim isn't. So there you are.
I see. Are you an arrogant git?
I'm not. But if I'm good at something, I don't mind telling everyone that I'm good at it.
Who's responsible, out of you three here, do you think, for this team not winning?
Miriam.
And why?
We didn't know exactly what products to get, so we got lots of them. Because we took 15 to her, there was no excuse for picking the wrong products. She was happy with the products that day, and it looks like, in the end, the product didn't win the day for us.
Tell me something. Not once in the hour did I ever hear her say, right, people, members of the public out there, we've sold 166 of these, they're going very, very well.
We've done our bit. Miriam chose which information to relay. Now, the fact is, she did a good job. You've said it yourself, she did a good presenting. Then we were giving her information. If she doesn't audio link it, you don't see that, sir.
Well, she might have done a good presenting job here. I'm still at sea about whether she'd done a good job as a team manager. Once I have understood, Miriam, that I will be fed by some person over an earpiece, immediately I would have said, I only want one of you at a time.
It was something that I left in their hands, but I told them that I wanted them to split.
No, why'd you leave it in their hands?
Because I told them...
It should have been a direction from you.
I directed them to split the responsibility of production.
Well, split means to me half an hour you, half an hour then. Doesn't mean let him talk for 30 seconds and you talk for 30 seconds, surely. I don't think that you two in particular have given me a good enough explanation in the current task that we're discussing. But on the other hand, I think Miriam made fatal error in not making sure that she only had one of you there and didn't actually give you more direction. Off you go outside. I'm going to have a little bit more time to think about this. But whatever happens, one of you is going to get fired.
I think Tim hasn't said much today to justify what he has done on this task.
Miriam could have carried off that job without either of them being at the end. I thought they added precious little.
Well, I think she's got a lot to answer to, Nick. No. I'm sorry.
The mistake
she's got a lot to answer
was
to.
Was not controlling them. She had no hand in the product mix, all right? They did. Right? And they were poor producers. That's the truth of it. They were poor producers. And of the two poor producers, Tim was streets ahead of Paul.
Well, I think, you know, that Miriam could have said, I only want one of you talking.
But that's her fault.
That is her fault.
That is her fault. No one else's. Mm-hmm. I mean, as I said, you'd have respect for her if she would have said, this isn't a job for two people. Don't both talk.
Yes.
Francis, could you send the three of them in, please? Tim, first time, really, you've been in the firing line. Honestly, not impressed. You haven't convinced me why I shouldn't fire you today, to be perfectly frank with you. I'm struggling. Miriam, past performances, possibly. Paul, you are a renegade, an absolute renegade. The thing is, I see a lot of me in you, so I'm not too worried about you, actually. You'll go on in life, and perhaps you'll learn a little bit more to temper down that temper of yours so you get on with people. I'm sorry, Paul. I'm very sorry. I do like you as a person. I'm sorry to have these say these things to you. But I'm even more sorry when I've got to tell you, Miriam, you're fired.
Thanks for the experience. It was amazing.
Tough one, tough one. And you two, I've got a lot to think about tonight when you put your head on the pillow. I think I was truthful in the end as to what it boiled down to.
But she didn't manage them in the task.
But she didn't.
Hang in there and do your best you can there.
Take that.
No past issues, anything. I hope you know that. See ya.
What the hell happened there? But when he came straight to me,
and he said,
I thought, that's
nice
it.
Tie.
You know, I started straightening my tie. I see a lot of you and me, but Paul, it breaks my heart, blah, 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 blah. I thought, start the engine. Mim, you're fired.
Paul is a tiger. Right, he's a tiger. I'm perhaps thinking that he might be able to change. Tim, he stayed here today simply because of past performance. If you had to judge it on today, he's a goner. You know I've made mistakes in the past, and maybe I've made a mistake here, but we'll see.
I think that it was Paul's time to go in terms of what I've seen of him, in terms of past tasks, in terms of his attitude, in terms of his, you know, the way he works. Yeah, I think it was definitely his time to go. I'm very, very surprised Paul's got this far. I'm glad to see that it wasn't an easy decision for Sir Alan. That is somewhat flattering. And no, I feel fine. I feel that, you know, he gave some reasons as to, you know, why he'd fired me, and one is that I hadn't made a decision regarding their production style, which he felt was a fatal error. I personally don't agree, because I think it was product choice that actually was more responsible.
One job, now just four candidates. Sir Alan's search for his apprentice continues. Next week on The Apprentice, the final four are put under the microscope.
What's going to happen is that you lot are going to go through a grueling interview.
She's a very forceful woman.
I've got a problem with you.
Okay.
Okay.
I don't think I've pissed anybody off, Sir Alan. I'm equal to any man out there.
Who do you think is going to win?
Me.
Are you here for the money?
Money's a part of it.
I just think there's a lack of substance there.
Out of the 10 tasks that we've done to date, I've been on the winning team 8 times.
Of the four, he's the only one that could do it.
I tend to get on with most people.
If it wasn't The Apprentice, he would apply for Blind Date or any other show.
I'm Italian, I do have a temper, definitely.
That's not an excuse for having a temper.
Very aggressive.
I found it all quite boring.
You'd have trouble with him, he'd have trouble with you.
If I was Sir Alan, I would employ me.